had a hair transplant. Is my hair density going to cover my full head? I'm concerned about my density. I had a hair transplant on September 15th. It has been 1.5 months since. Below are my photos. My scalp looks clean and I can see my scalp. I'm concerned about my hair density. Will it be enough or would I have to go for another transplant? Doctor told me he had transplanted 5,500 hairs, but density looks thin. Will it be enough to make me look not bald? Please see the photos and let me know. Can I expect some growth of hair to cover my scalp before February 1st? I have a special function to attend.
Thank you for your question. You have submitted several photos, and in the narrative of your question, you describe having undergone approximately 5,500 grafts in September, and you are concerned because you feel like your scalp looks relatively bald and that you have a deadline of February to look good for an event. And so you want to get an idea of what of whether or not you'll have adequate coverage. Well, I can certainly assist you with this question. A little bit about my background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon, and I've been practicing hair transplant surgery for over 20 years in Manhattan and in Long Island. In addition, I'm also the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, which is a non-surgical alternative to hair loss using extracellular matrix and platelet-rich plasma. And I'll discuss this in more detail later on. In fact, we have helped many people who have had hair transplants done elsewhere during the early post-operative period. So I can give you some sense of what you can expect. So to begin with, the number of grafts you received was a relatively high number for any hair transplant surgery. And I think you are more than aware of that. When people shop for hair transplant surgery, very often they're always looking for numbers of grafts. Well, unfortunately, the hard limit is the actual number of grafts you can get out of a donor area. In addition, it is also very important to understand that looking at your photos, you have very advanced hair loss, which means the surface area that needs to be covered is very large. That means that you're taking, let's say for argument's sake, that all 5,500 grafts survive, then you still have an incredible lack of overall density compared to when you had hair. When we think of numbers, prior to hair loss, it is not unusual to say that you would have approximately 100,000 hairs in this area. Now, when you first notice hair loss, you've already lost half your hair. Now, of course, just looking at the density and the surface area, to give you an idea of what natural density is, it is not unusual to have people have 50 to 75 hairs per square centimeter naturally. In hair transplant surgery, it's more common to put no more than 20 hairs per square centimeter. So of course there's a lot of math here, but in the end, it is likely you will get coverage, but you will not get the type of coverage where it doesn't look like your hair is thin. Nonetheless, hair transplant can be very effective in making one look like they're not as bald as they were prior to surgery. And I think that's critically important for you to understand. This is a discussion that I'm assuming you had prior to your surgery in order to get proper informed consent. In our practice, what we do for patients like yourself who come to us after they've had a transplant and also to understand a little bit about the phases you're in, just to get to that issue of why you look maybe like you have less hair than you did initially, In hair transplant surgery, there are two things that happen after the surgery. Immediately after the surgery, things can look very good. You have all these short little hairs, you feel them, it feels great, and you're optimistic. But within a few months, it's not unusual for a good number of those grafts to go through what's called shock loss. Shock loss means that the hairs temporarily go into a telogen phase. They shed out. Doesn't mean that the hair, the roots of the hairs or the dermal papilla are gone, but just the top of the hair. In addition, if there is existing hair, then there's collateral shock loss, which means existing hair that was there can shock out. Now, if you also had a lot of hair grafts, it's also not unusual to have collateral loss that's more long-term because of the incidental trauma to the existing hairs. It is something that is always accepted in hair transplant, basically because it is rationalized that if you are going to lose, you're better off losing a thinning hair that's going to go away anyway and replace it with a thicker hair from the permanent donor zone. Now, that being said, the timeline is concerning because from September to February is about 5 months, and the length of time that we typically tell our patients after surgery to expect they're most likely to have their full results is around a year. And for people who are slow growers, who have more advanced hair loss, it's not unusual to see somebody look even better at 18 months. Which means that your timeline is a little bit tight, and I'm not sure you're going to be able to feel comfortable with your result by that point. But it doesn't mean that you're not going to see more hair growth as time goes on. To go back to the comment about what we do for patients like yourself who come to us, we've developed a process called hair regeneration. And hair regeneration is a non-surgical alternative to hair transplant, which works very effectively for both men and women with thinning hair. In fact, when we looked at our data, we actually saw that hair regeneration in terms of density can actually yield the equivalent of two hair transplants in the right candidate. Now, when it comes to someone who's had hair transplant, who is aware of the success that we've had with what was initially the intention of this system was to improve our hair transplant results, which means to improve graft survival and to improve donor area healing, patients do come to have us treat them at a critical time, usually within the first 1 to 3 months, and I prefer usually somewhere around the 1 to 2 month time, where we'll actually do this injection to help their grafts heal better, to help their donor area heal better, and to help their thinning hair actually become thicker. And we've had a lot of success with that. And the strategy of doing that is often the result of someone like yourself who is nervous at this critical point where they don't look like they have a lot of activity going on. And then they learn about what we do and they come and we decide whether or not it's appropriate for them. So in your situation, I'm not necessarily saying you should pursue hair regeneration, but I'm saying that you need to talk to your doctor about what to expect by February, because I would say conservatively you may get some growth, but you're not going to get the full growth of what you want. And as far as the overall coverage, I think that it's important to understand that hair transplant is still a compromise. It's not an ideal solution, but when you're dealing with a limited donor area, regardless of the method, whether it's a technique of FUT, FUE, robotic technology, whatever you want to call it, the limitation is the donor area, and it's clearly you got as much as what would be described often as two transplants in one session. So there's no question you and your doctor came to terms with doing something that many would call a mega session. So that being said, I think your communication with your doctor is very important. You may find the use of some topical fibers and other things that can be maybe helpful for your event. But in the meantime, once you learn more, you'll be able to strategize what you can do for your February deadline. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.